I've got some stuff for Mailbag. You might be interested in this. Stick around, see if it's something you need. What did I buy this time? If you're not already subscribed, make sure you do. Right, let's see what's in here. It's a module. What is this? Ah, it's a USB tester. Well, that's kind of come dislodged. It's not a big deal, is it? It's got to put the pins back in. Let's just sort that out. So this is for testing USB. You've got USB-C, USB micro, and got a couple of buttons on the side there, which are marked as TRG and stop. I guess that's trigger and stop, start, stop. Got rotary encoder just here. With press, it's got a high current USB connector, it looks like. It's got quite wide terminals on there, that's interesting. Let's zoom into that. Here we go. See those terminals in there? The left and right ones, they're really wide. Can you see them? There you go. Really wide terminals. Very interesting, I haven't seen those before. That's a new one on me. I should probably plug this in and see if it does something. Let me get a cable. Okay, so over there on my bench I've got this little USB outlet thing here, which is, does quite high currents and stuff. If I need to plug anything USB in, it goes into there. So let's plug this in here and we'll see what happens. Upside down. 5.1 volts, okay. Is that showing up? Yes it is. My meter over there also, it shows the current draw on that as well. I'm not convinced of its accuracy, but it shows the current draw. It says 1 amp. So stop is actually on as well. So that's seen, see it says stop. And I push stop to make it start. Now it's off. And now it's on. At 1 amp. Okay. That seems right. Can I increase the current? Yes, I can. Voltage is dipping. Here we go, little cooling fans kicked in. 1.5 amps. It's supposed to be able to do a couple of amps, this thing, so let's wind it up to 2 amps. Yeah, sort of 4.5 volts, it's probably about the limit of where you want to go to. So, cool. That seems to work alright. What's this trig button do? C20. Oh, that's probably because it's got battery options as well. FCP, AFC. C2.0, 3.0. What do those do? There's probably a manual for this online. So go and check out the listing for this thing if you're interested in a USB tester. Might be useful for testing power banks maybe as well. Seems alright, so it's got these other USB connectors on there too. But yeah, there'll be a link down below for this thing. Go and check it out. It might be interesting if you're interested in a decent USB load. It seems to be alright. I mean, you can do a couple of amps. Seems to be nice enough. Check it out. Yeah, let's see what's in here. I think that's it. Yep, that'll be it. So here are two flex cables. Okay, so these are, I believe these are used based on the shapes of them. I think there's a used cables. These are used for trackpads on MacBooks. So those old MacBook trackpad cables. So I don't mind them being used, you know, at least you know they're original parts and they're probably going to be good quality and not likely to have any issues unless they've also got some kind of fault. Have a close look at these connectors, make sure they look okay. Yeah, it looks alright. Pretty sure one's alright. Check out the circuitry. It's having trouble focusing because I'm rather close to it and I've got high zoom. And it's got these reflections off the plastic as well. So yeah, that looks okay. There's nothing there which stands out as being a problem. They don't look like they've been liquid damaged or anything like that. Yeah, they look fine, so they're probably alright. I don't mind getting used parts in China. I mean, you're pretty sure they're going to be okay. So I needed one of these for a MacBook I'm repairing. So I thought, well, I'll need one, and I'll just get two. What's this one? This looks suspiciously similar, doesn't it? Okay, these are some keyboard connectors for MacBooks. Sometimes they get liquid damage because they're on a prone spot on the board, because they're on the edge of the board, so you get liquid damage on them. And I've had a couple like that where I've managed to rescue them, but it's been close. I think I've had to replace one previously, or I've got one which is damaged which I haven't replaced yet. I think it's the lever part was broken off, but it still works, something like that anyway. So I thought I'd got some more, you know, then I've at least got some when I do need them. Next thing, don't forget to subscribe if you're not already subscribed to the channel. Please have a chat down below in the comments, you know, if you want to hear your opinions and, you know, hear what you have to say. So make sure you check out the comments and have a read and, or contribute and actually ask questions, because I do read all the comments. I read every comment that gets posted. So, and I will reply to them if I think it, if I have time to reply and it's seen something like that deserves a reply or something like that anyway. I do try to reply, so make sure you check out the comments and share the video too if there's anything you think people might want to be interested in. Now this has got a bit of a story behind this, I know what this is now. It's a roll of solder, which I'm going to try out and see how good it is. It's Duratec, which comes from a local electronic supplier. I'll tell you the story in a second. And here's a can of spray, obviously sealed in case it leaks. Okay. And a flyer. I'll show you the flyer, I suppose, and see where it comes from. At least they pack things quite well, I have to say. This is from JK Electronics. Okay, this is New Zealand and Australian retailer. Now, the reason I got this is because anyone that's seen my Twitter feed, if you follow my Twitter, you would have seen it on there. If you don't follow my Twitter feed, check me out on Twitter. I'm on there if you use Twitter. The Defpom, same as my YouTube name. It's linked in the... I think it's in, is it in the description? I can't remember. It's certainly my about page anyway. You know, I'm on Twitter. And the story is, not so much about this, it's just a circuitable cleaner stuff. Let's get some whilst I was doing an order. I purchased this solder here because I tried to buy some solder from RS Components. Like, normally that shouldn't be an issue, you just go and buy solder. It's a consumable item, it's just one of the things you know, you get it when you need it. So I tried to buy some multi-core solder. Same as this one, like I'm already using. It's set to thinner grade. This one's 1.2mm, one I wanted to get, it was 0.7mm. Ordered about 5-6 weeks ago now, 6 weeks ago. I got an email a couple of days ago saying, oh, we can't supply this to you, only we can't, won't sell it to individuals. Like, what? It's just a roll of solder. So, but RS took it off my order. So it took them 5 weeks to notice that I ordered some solder and they didn't want to sell it to me. So I thought, right, okay, I'll go and buy some solder from JCars. And also purchase some from somewhere else as well. I've actually done a video on that, which you would have seen before this one comes out. So, by the time you see this video, I would have actually published a video on the solder issue. So if you haven't seen that one yet, go and check it out, it goes into a bit more detail. But yeah, so this is Duratec, so I don't know how good this is. 2% flux, doesn't seem to say what the flux actually is. So it's quite a low flux, 2%, but that's alright, and it's quite thin. So we'll see how this goes, I mean, I'll give it a try. This stuff I actually find has got too much flux in it, really. It tends to leave a bit too much mess, which is then hard to clean. But it's a good solder, it works well. You know, maybe because it's got so much flux in it, but watch that video when you see this one, if you haven't seen the other one first. This is a just circuitable cleaner. Removes flux and stuff like that too. So, it's quite expensive, this stuff. But sometimes you need this more than IPA. IPA sometimes just won't do it, and this will get off the really stubborn stuff. So yeah, make sure you subscribe. Click the bell icon. Give us a thumbs up, share the video, all the usual stuff, and thank you very much to my Patreons who support me and help me to buy things for Mailbag and help support the channel. It still makes a loss, it still costs me money, but it helps. It means I can buy more stuff instead of, you know, it's a little bit less. Anyway, thanks for watching, catch you later. Was that saying? That's showing nothing on there. Why is it showing nothing on there? That's weird. Have I not started? How do I use this thing? 1 amp, start. Okay, well, I'm not making much sense of this. Stop. On. Now it's drawing current. Right. So, stop is actually on as well. Zoom into this. So that scene, see, it says stop. And I push stop to make it start. Focus, you bastard.